Welcome to this brief guide on how to use instant polls in Microsoft Teams. As an organizer or a co-organizer of a meeting, using a poll is a great way to get some feedback from the participants of your meeting. However, it does require a little bit of work beforehand. If you're looking for a quick, simple thumbs up or thumbs down sort of response, today I'm going to show you how to use instant polls to make that easier than ever before. Here in my Teams meeting, you'll notice I don't currently have the polls application in my app bar. If this is the same for yourself, simply click on the plus icon to add an app. You'll notice I currently have polls in my recently used apps, but if you don't have that there, simply type polls into the search field and the top search result should be the polls application. Selecting this will give you a pop-up with any permissions that you need to accept. I've previously accepted these permissions, so what I'm getting instead is a simple What's New in Polls pop-up, which I can then use the Save button to dismiss. Now that I've gotten rid of that application little pop-up, what you'll notice I have the Polls application in my app bar, and I now have a side pane that is currently open with a list of suggestions for polls, including a great little How Are You Feeling Today poll, which I could easily add in, as well as an optional Emotion Word Cloud option. However, the one we want to talk about today is the instant polls found at the bottom, with quick options for a yes-no sort of response, a quick thumbs up, thumbs down response, and then last but not least, a heart or a broken heart option. There's also a quick settings option, which you can select to have a couple of quick changes that you can make to the poll, such as the ability to record names of the respondents and share the aggregated results with the respondents after the poll has been completed. Now, to initiate one of these polls, simply select the button. In this case, I've done the thumbs up and thumbs down. And in just a few seconds, all users of the meeting will have the poll appear in front of them, and they can quickly and easily select either the thumbs up or the thumbs down icon as per their response. They can also see that in this case, their names will be recorded and the results will be shared after. Selecting the thumbs up will let me see that there's been one respondent to this poll, and that's me, and it's 100% thumbs up. If I was to use one of the other options, such as the yes-no response, I'll get the same style of pop-up, but instead of a thumbs up and a thumbs down, I simply get quick and easy yes and no answers. And the aggregated results of both of these polls will be available for all to see in the meeting chat immediately following the poll's completion. And that is how you use instant polls in Microsoft Teams. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.